Hi, in this tutorial, we're going to start implementing our microservice. For this video, that means we're going to add the Java code for the classes we defined in the last video. Now, since there aren't too many classes, our plan for this video is just to go over the code for every class. This is the fourth video in a larger playlist for creating microservices in Java. You can find the link for the full playlist in the text below. To start with, let's create a class that represents our trivia question. We decided in the last video our trivia question should have the question, four possible answers, the correct answer, a hint with an identifier, and a date the question was last modified. The last modified date will let us take advantage of caching. This object should be immutable, so we'll make sure nothing is editable by marking everything final. We'll also make sure everything is defined in the constructor, and we'll only provide getters. Next, I'll just mention we created a builder for this class. It doesn't do anything too interesting. We defeat it values and the builder returns us an instance of our trivia question class. The important task is you can't create a trivia question without defining all of the values. The build method returns an instance of trivia question. Every setter in the builder sets a value and returns a builder. The complete source code is on GitHub and each of these setters follow the same form as these two. For now, we want to use a simple array to hold our trivia questions, but in the future, we'll want to move this to a database. To make our lives easier in later videos, we'll create an interface called Trivia Question Accessible that represents access to our data. This way, when we need to swap the array for a real database, the amount of code we need to change is minimal. Interfaces are a great way to decouple classes. Then we'll create a Trivia Question Array Access class. This is our array implementation of Trivia Question Accessible. We'll also add a method to load our data. We're using the builder to add trivia questions to our array. GetQuestionByIndex will return one particular question by the index provided. This is by index, not ID. If we need it by ID, we have GetQuestionByID. This looks at the identifier for the question and returns the matching question. GetRandomQuestion will return one question at random. We don't know which one it'll be, but that's the idea. If we need to get a list of questions, we have the getQuestionList. This method will only return a list of 10 questions max. The reason is, if someone calls our microservice and asks for all of the questions, that could tie up our service for a long time while it prepares the response. It's better to return a few quickly and then let them ask for the next set. We'll do this by offering an offset as a parameter. If we pass 0, we'll get the first 10 questions. If we pass 11, we'll get the next 10 questions starting at the index 11. We might already know the questions we want to ask. For example, imagine a trivia round where multiple players are all getting the same questions. We'd want to return a list of questions predetermined by the system. For that, we'll create a getSpecifiedQuestions list. This takes a list of IDs and returns them in a list. Now, this implementation isn't the fastest or most efficient, but we'll improve it when we move to a database. In order for the clients to know how many times they need to call for questions, we need to tell them how many questions are in the list. We'll give them a method that returns the number of trivia questions in our database. At this point, we have a data object and a way to get to the data. Next, we need to add endpoints to access the data from outside our microservice. We're going to return JSON using REST. JSON has pluses and minuses, but it's a good general solution for communication since almost any client will be able to understand our data. In fact, if you're following along the Swift videos, we've already seen how to get JSON data from a REST endpoint for iOS devices. We'll create REST endpoints using JAX-RS to access our microservice. We'll first create the application class. This is Trivia App. Now, this class doesn't have much functionality. You can consider it like a main method. This is where WildFly Swarm enters our code. We define the application path here. The application path is the starting path for our API. This class extends the JAX-RS application class. We'll also return our directory from here. It produces JSON data for GET requests. Our GET directory method builds two links to the return to the caller. Links inform the caller what services are available. We'll return self, which is just a pointer to what URL produced this response, and a questions link. The reason why we're doing this is we want some other system to reach our API through one published endpoint. That endpoint is /trivia. From there, a system should be able to discover how to navigate our API programmatically. The link for the questions will take them to the questions endpoint. We don't have an HTTP body to return for this endpoint, but we'll return status code OK, the links, and a last modified date. In the future, we'll change that date to match the date our code was created. This will help clients cache responses. Finally, we'll create three endpoints for the questions in our trivia question resource. The starting path for all of these will be /questions. The constant starting offset represents the value for the first trivia question, 0. It's there mostly to avoid hard coding the constant, and it makes the code a bit more readable. The page size constant defines how many questions are returned per request. We're going with 10, but if we find that that's too small or big, we can change it later. This endpoint will return the complete list of questions 10 at a time. We don't want to return all the questions in one go, but because it can create a bottleneck in our system. What if we have millions of questions? If the system is spending too much time responding to one very long request, other users can't access our system. We'll provide links for the system to navigate to other pages of our data, like next and previous. Finally, we'll build and return the JSON response. We'll create an endpoint for getting the total count of questions. This will be /count path under the /questions path. We're returning the number of questions in the message body and as a header variable. We'll also need to get a particular question by its identifier or random question. If an ID number is provided, we'll assume the request is for a particular question. If the path /random is provided, we'll return a random question. And that wraps up the code. If you see anything confusing or anything that could be improved upon, let me know. Now that we have basic functionality, we need to look at making sure it works as intended with unit tests. Thanks for watching the video. You can find the source code and the complete transcripts on deegeu.com. Next, we'll take a look at testing our trivia microservice. Now, if you like what you're seeing or if you have any questions, let me know in the comments or on deegeu.com. Please like and share, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.